Hi all, welcome back to more 7 Days to Die, Alpha 15. Happy Monday everybody. As you can see, we are out and about a little bit earlier than normal in the game, because we are gonna head over to, over to the new area that we've been exploring, out by where the trader's at to set up our new base. So, without further ado, we're going to head over there. Once I get a little bit further along here, I will probably do a quick cut and bring you back when we're a little further along. But I just want to make sure we're not getting jumped by any zombies, because, well, if we do, at least that'll be some entertainment for you. Oh, so, yeah, happy Monday. For those who didn't make it to the live stream over the weekend, no worries. Or I should say on Friday. We did do a little bit of a live stream for the Friday, the normal Friday live stream. We did 7 Days to Die. Basically, went ahead and got over to the trader. And looks like we may have hit the render issue again. Yes, we did. Okay, so now somebody was saying if you morph the terrain, it will reload. But you have to do enough damage that it morphs. So we'll see how this works. Because I may need to do a quick reload here. Actually, you know what? Did I bring any? Yes, I did. Hey, look at that. All right, so we'll go ahead and take this out really quick. Now, this is one of the problems with Alpha 15, because what it does is when you first load into the map, it renders everything in before you start playing. So if you start, you can force start the game a little bit early. Let's see. Did it. All right. Looks like I am going to have to do a quick quick reload here. So I'm going to go ahead and do a quick cut, and I will bring you right back. And we're back. Just had a small zombie issue to deal with, but that's been taken care of, and we are on our way over to the waypoint that we've set. Lots of resource rocks. It's always a good thing to see. I'm gonna break you down for scrap along with you. What the? Where'd you come from? That's the other thing that I'm really disliking about Alpha 15 is that the zombies don't have footsteps, as well as the fact that they just seem to decide to spawn in from time to time. Oh, all right. We're gonna scrap you as well. Okay, so let's head on, shall we? Oh, it would be really beneficial if you know, they would fix some of the little problems. So, for those who have not been paying attention to the development blog, Joel, aka Madmole, has released over the weekend. He did another live stream, and so Alpha 16 is already on the horizon. Basically, I think they were really disappointed in what was going on with Alpha 15, and were a little underwhelmed by the reception. Because let's face it, they promised a bunch of things and they backed a lot of that out before Alpha 15 launched. So what they did release is nice, don't get me wrong. I like it, it looks much better. But as we were talking about over the weekend, there was a live stream with the Broken Ankle crew, and a couple of us were talking, you know, that it's sad when you look at it from the perspective of inside the game. If you have been playing 7 Days to Die for a while, and you look at Alpha 15, it's like, wow, this is gorgeous. They did a great job with it. And then you look at it from the perspective, from an unbiased perspective outside of the game, And you can see where a lot of the people that are criticizing it for its appearance really, you know, are not wrong. We're not, you know, it's like, you have to remember this game engine has been revamped a couple of times, but it's still an older game. I mean, originally it was built on what? Basically Minecraft. Aw, man. What do I have that I can get rid of? You know what? Get rid of that really quick. Alright, so, now that we... Yeah. Let's go ahead and get rid of the basic bandage. Actually, you know what? I could have scrapped that. Oh, well. I'm not worried about it. It's only two cloth. Of course, I say that, and, you know, 5 minutes from now, I'm going to need two cloth. So, yeah, as I was saying, basically, if you look at it from outside of the game, the graphics, even though they look great, you know, in relation to other 7 Days to Die builds, oh, man, really? Come on. Just trying to get one thing done around here. Sheesh. One thing. Let me get one thing done. actually, scrap that. Grab that. Okay. But yeah, as I was saying, when you look at it in relation to other builds of 7 Days to Die, you know, it does look good. But when you look at it from outside of the 7 Days to Die, you know, basically sphere of game, what you see is, you know, something that is pretty dated. I mean, let's be honest here. I mean, a lot of the graphics that you see are comparable to what you would see in MMOs, you know, 5-6 years ago. And that's not a bad thing, because one of the things that I think people outside of the 7 Days to Die community really don't look at is the fact that while, yes, these are dated graphics, this is a fully voxel world. You know, there is a lot that you can do here that you can't do in some of the games that you see, you know, that are pushing the bleeding edge of technology. Yes, those games are, the games are catching up, but as it is right now, there is a lot that you can't really do in a lot of the modern games that you can do here. Let's see, can we get... Yes? Uh-oh. Oh, hello. Yeah, that silent step thing is really annoying. Hey, look, venison. And I hear another... Well, I guess not. There's somebody else over here? No. Okay. So, but yeah, when you take it in that type of context, I think that you do see a, you know, something that is worth the time to put into it. So that's my little industry rant for the day, I think. And on that note, what we're going to do is I'm going to go ahead and do a quick cut because, well, unless you want to hear me rant some more about this kind of stuff, and just ramble on. I'm going to go ahead and do a cut, and I will bring you back when we are back to the new base area. All right? We'll see you shortly. Welcome back. Okay, so we are a lot closer to where we need to be. As you can see, we're about halfway there. But I did want to show you something that we haven't really looked at yet, and that's the new ranger station point of interest. Well, I shouldn't call it the ranger station. It's the, you know, the wilderness retreat, I guess, of some kind. I don't remember what the official POI name for it is, but this is the house that you generally find, or you can sometimes find, with good gun safes in. There we go. Oh, you know what? Scrap that. Eat that. Take those and look for the zombies that are closing in on us, because I heard the little giggling. Ah, there they are. So let's go ahead and kill her all. See, that's what I'm talking about, the new hitboxes with the zombies. They tend to... The arrows tend to scatter a little bit more, and the hitboxes are a little bit off with them. So you end up missing a lot more in Alpha 15 than you used to. But again, you know, it is what it is. Let's see here. Do we have... I don't need the dirt. I'm looking for all the stuff I need to be balancing, and I'm carrying dirt. So let's go take a look at this place. I'm going to see what they've done with it. Oh, this is the stone. So this one actually looks like it is the ranger's house. So it doesn't look like they've really changed a whole lot with it. There's been some new bird nests added. As far as this goes, it looks like this isn't the new one, unfortunately. So we're going to go ahead and continue on. That way we can get to the new build location. Now, I am in the... I think this is the Pine Forest biome. So there is a lot of these little campsites. So if you're looking for easy resources, this is actually a good place for them. As long as you don't let yourself get swarmed, because, well, getting swarmed out here is a bad thing. Alright. Anything? Yeah, as you can see, I've already been through here once. I think I've already got all of this, right? Yeah, I've already looted all this, and that's the bone shiv. Okay, so we're going to continue on. I'm going to go ahead and do one more cut, and I'll bring you back when we're a little bit further there. Actually, I'll probably bring you back when we get to the where I'm planning on building. Right, so we will see you shortly. And we're back. So this is the general area that I was talking about building in. I'm thinking I'm going to do something very similar to what I had previously over in the other area where we've got the bedroll currently, where we're going to build a platform style house, but I think I'm going to do that over there on the other side, because when you get over where, on the far side of where that deer is, it actually the water gets really deep very close to shore, and the reason we want to do that is because we want to have, you know, at least five we want the house to be at least five blocks off the seabed, because that way the zombies can't hit it when they're under it. The only thing they'll be able to do is to attack the supports. And the idea is that we'll have enough supports there that it shouldn't be an issue. Right? So, what we're going to do, let me go ahead and get out of here. As you can see, it is a bit warm in this biome. That is one of the things that I don't like. The temperatures are a little bit, well, let's just say, out of scale. Alright, so, let's see here, do I have anything? I don't have anything processing, so I am safe to do this. Now, what we will eventually do is, in this cliffside here, I'm going to actually burrow into that. I'm thinking I want to have a forge area out there in the water where you can see the holy chicken. But I'm thinking I'm going to build my forge area out there on that small island, and then we will have a bit of a path, like a walkway over, a bridge over, and then that will lead into an entrance area. And what I'll do is I will dig all of this out once we get a little bit better tools going, so we can do this a little bit faster. And we're going to burrow into the stone of that mountain, and that's where we'll have ultimately our base. As part of doing this, I wanted to have something that we could use right now. And so that's what we are going to work on here. We actually want this to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, you know what? We're going to have to go down here, because I really don't want to have a situation where this is going to be on uneven terrain. 3, 4, 5, 5, and let me go get some air before I drowned here. Alright. So, if you guys are going to do that, let's do it this way then. We'll pick you up. We're going to put you guys there. 2, 3, 4, and 5. And grab some air. Yay! Underwater building in 7 days to die. Gotta love it. Okay. And then what we'll do is when we get to the point where we have dirt that we can expend, we will actually come back and backfill this a little bit. Eventually, I'm going to replace everything under it with reinforced concrete. But for now, this works nicely. 3, 4, come on, get me up there, thank you. And 5. And you'll see the water backfill. So they did fix that. Water does now flow between these the frames. There we go. And that puts us up here on a nice platform, 5 out of the water. Or 4. 5 off the ground, and then we just say, just like this. Okay. And we just go ahead and fill all of this in. As you can see, towards the second half of Alpha 14, right before Alpha 15 came out, they changed the way that the hitboxes were working on frames and such as well. And basically, we ended up with a situation where it became really awkward to place frames now. So, oh, that's okay. We'll do with we. All we can do is deal with what we've got, right? Yeah, I know I'm overheating. So we're gonna go ahead and fill all of this in. And now one of the reasons I wanted to build in this particular area is not only do we have easy access to stone and potentially resources in there, all of the trees that you see here, we're actually going to be able to, and I'm going to do this, I'm going to backfill a lot of the lake over here and have a bit of a tree farm going as well. That way I don't have to worry about going out and finding and harvesting wood, we'll just have a ready supply of it. But this is just to get us started. Okay, so now before we get too much further in, where is, let's see, I want to put the ladder on this side, I think. And see if we can get it to work a little better than it did last time. Did I not bring the ladder with me? I didn't bring the ladder with me. That's okay. We can make one, so I'm not worried about it. So what we're going to do here is fill all these in, hopefully. If we don't have enough cobble, then we can always make a little bit more. It's fairly easy to get the stuff to make it. We have clay right there, which is another reason to build in this area. So when you're picking your bases, you definitely want to try and pick an area that has as much of the resource as you think you're going to need. Water is obviously something that's good to have. Sand is good to have, and as you can see, we have that. We have sand, we have clay, we have dirt. So we're going to be able to very quickly build out what we need to in order to survive. So, and we just have to wait for the water to backfill there. We're not going to worry too much about it, though. Okay, go ahead and do this. Yes, I have to say, like I've said earlier, I am rather impressed with the overall playability of Alpha 15, and yes, we do need to go grab stuff. And am I What did I have that just backfilled? Okay. Oops. Actually wanted that. No, we don't want you there. We want you there. Thank you. Come on. Let me up. Thank you. Okay. And it works for now. Now, I don't want to have to rely on that method to get out of the water. While it is much more secure than probably anything else we would be able to do. Oh, look, we've got a zombie over there saying hello. We're going to go ahead and do this. And then basically, like I did with the last place that we built, we're going to go ahead and take all of this away. Puppy wanting to be internet famous. Hello, puppy. We want to do three. Actually, we want four, right? No, we want three. We want three there. Right, two and three. Two and three. And then we're going to do the same on this side. We're gonna say here. So once again, we have our window out into the world. I don't think I'm going to put a window on the edges on this one. I might at some point come back and change my mind on that, but we'll see. Now, I don't really want to build this up too much because I am trying to avoid putting too much weight on the unfinished frames down below. That just tends to be a bad idea. So that's going to be sloped. 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 Okay. And then that will give us our nice angled roof in case we get, you know, any type of inclement weather that's going to be a pain to deal with. So let's go ahead and upgrade at least the frame area here. We're going to have to kill that zombie, I think. Okay, so that gets us started. And again, I'm just upgrading these enough that I don't have to come back and do this again. And if you have a choice, always pick the one that is the least amount of blocks to remove. Okay, and we are going to swap. Where are my... Oh, there. So this is going to be our window. So let's go ahead and do chest. We're going to have our sleeping bag here. We'll have our forge and... Well, actually, you know what? We'll do our forge and campfire in this side. And then we'll have our sleeping bag over here so that it's out of the way. But now that we have that out of the way, we can actually go ahead and make our door. Let's go ahead and upgrade this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and do one last... Actually, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and finish this thing off camera. And when we come back next time, we should have a house and the beginnings of a base. So... on that note, I want to thank you all for stopping in today. Hope you enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun hanging out with you and sharing what the plans are. When you come back, hopefully we will have more of a base and I won't have died in the meantime. And yeah, so if you enjoyed the episode, make sure you hit that like button. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them down in the section below the video. And yeah, as always, folks, take care and be safe out there, everybody. Oh, so much more to do.